Dear city, comes from the Latin word meaning to speak. Dear city 来自于拉丁语的单词，就它意思就是去说的意思。So, a dictionary is a treasury of words for speaking. 所以呢，这个单词叫词典。词典是一个什么东西呢？是一个宝库，单词的宝库。这个单词用来干嘛？说的。所以合起来，说话用的单词的宝库。And a contradiction.With its prefix contra against, speaks against or denies something. Contradiction, C-O-N-T-R-A, 它这边说了是相反的意思，那就是指反驳或者是否认某事情。Diction, choice of words, especially with regard to correctness, clearness, or effectiveness. Clarity of speech, 选择就是对于单词的选择，尤其是关于这个正确的、清晰的或者有效的，所以叫措辞的意思。还有叫做清晰的发音。Our CEO is determined to appear in some TV ads, but the first needs to work on his diction with the vocal coach. 我们的首席执行官 is determined to 决定去出镜，在一些电视广告中出镜。但是呢，首先他需要去练习他的措辞发音和谁呢？和这个。声乐教练。When your English teacher complains about some of the words you chose to use in an essay, she's talking about your diction. 当你的英语老师抱怨你在论文中所使用的一些单词，他谈论的其实你的措辞。She may also use the term when commenting on the word choices made by a poet and why a particular wordwas the best one possible in a particular line.
他也用这个术语，啥时候用呢？他在评论一首诗里面用的单词的时候，为什么某个词是最好的，在某行中用的最好的一个词。
Compare syntax, but the second meaning of diction is just as common, and your English teacher might use the one on you as well, especially when she is asked you to read something aloud and you mumble your way through it.
比较一下这个词，我们后面会讲到。但是呢，diction 的第二个意思更加的普遍，你的英语老师也使用这个意思，尤其是当他要求你去大声的读某个材料的时候，并且呢，你读的又磕磕绊绊的。那他就把这个词的含义用在你身上，清晰的发音。
Edict, an official announcement that has the force of law.
官方的叫宣布，那就是法律的意思，强迫、强行的意思，所以叫法令。
An order or command,
命令的意思。
In 1989, an edict by the leader of Iran pronouncing a death sentence on a British novelist stunned the world.
在1989年一个命令由这个伊朗领导人宣布的一个命令，什么宣布了一个死刑，对谁呢？对英国的作家宣布死刑。这件事情的话震惊了世界。合起来1989年伊朗领导人宣布判处一名英国小说家死刑，这件事情震惊了世界。
Edicts are few and far between in a democracy, since very few important laws can be made by a president or prime minister acting alone.
法令少之又少，在什么？在民主国家少之又少，因为很少的重要的法律是由总统或者首相单独去制定的。
But when a crisis arose in the Roman Republic,The Senate would appoint a dictator who would have the power to rule by edict.
当一个危机出现的时候，出现在什么地方？罗马共和国的时候，我们说元老院将会指派一名 dictator, 行政官，然后他有能力去发布法令，通过法令去执行统治。
The idea was that the dictator could make decisions quickly.Issuing its edicts faster than the Senate could act.
就过去的一个想法是什么？就执行官能够很快的做出决定，发布法令快于什么？ 元老院所做出的法令。When the crisis was over, the edicts were cancelled and the dictator usually retired from public life. 当危机结束的时候，法令就取消了，然后呢，行政长官通常就退出了公众生活。Things are different today. Dictators almost always install themselves in power, and they never give it up. 今天的话，这事情就不一样了。独裁者们几乎一直掌权 ，install 就建立在里面，建立在这个权力里面，那就要一直掌权，从不放弃。